Hey everyone, Jessica Jablonski with the Jablonski Group at Russell & Sotheby's International Realty, coming to you for another market update. So what's going on in the real estate market? Well, it is absolutely cranking. We've got like 8,000 homes on the market right now, which is nowhere near enough. We were saying the inventory was low at like 15,000 homes. So as you can imagine now at 8,000, we are really feeling it. Typically the Phoenix Metro, we close out like 7,000 to 9,000 homes per month. So 8,000 is nowhere near enough. So we need more homes to sell. So why is this happening? Well, obviously this whole COVID scenario, that was a big deal. A lot of people that maybe would have sold, pressed the pause button and decided to hold. But also we've got so much influx of people coming in. Many are dubbing it the wealth flight, if you will. And what's the wealth flight? It's people from California, or states like California, where income taxes are going up, corporate taxes are going up, there's a new proposed wealth tax, all of those things on these companies that, their balance sheets were already hurting because of COVID. That increase has been just enough to push some of these companies over the edge, to push the employees over the edge, to finally make that move. Jeffrey and I are talking daily to people in New York, California, Washington, all over, that are looking to make a shift. And the Phoenix market as a whole, the affordability in comparison is great. Income taxes are relatively low in comparison, so it's definitely a hot spot. I know that there's a lot of buyers out there that you guys are hoping for people to, or for the market to make a shift, and unfortunately I don't think that that's coming anytime soon. In fact, a reasonable expectation is that we're gonna see the prices continue to rise rapidly, really, probably through the end of the year and maybe even longer than that. And then, if affordability starts to suffer, then we may see that not rise as rapidly, but we're still expecting for an appreciating market. So, time is definitely not on your side. I hear a lot of people talking about, oh, we wanna wait till the market shifts. And I think it's gonna be quite some time before that happens. So, if it is something you are considering, I would really encourage you to start poking around. Interest rates are a big factor. If you are gonna be leveraging the property, meaning that you're gonna have a mortgage on the property, interest rates being below 3% right now is a big deal. It increases your buying power, obviously helps keep that monthly mortgage payment in check. I was talking to somebody the other day and I think they're locked in somewhere around like 2.66%. I mean, that is nuts. So take advantage if it's something that you are looking to, make a change. As for sellers, now's the time. So prices are going up rapidly. They're continuing to go up rapidly. You watch them, in the market, one house sells, the next house lists over that house. I mean, it is just up and up and up and up. We've seen this before. We saw it in 05, we saw it in 09, we saw it again in 2012. But what we also typically see is it, goes like this 2, 3, 4 months, and then you see kind of a rapid drop. And the reason for that is just that it's like the market just finally hits that benchmark where it's like, nope, can't go any higher. And so you'll see it kind of correct itself a little bit. So, now is a great time to wring out every last dollar you can get out of it, especially if it's something, we're talking to a lot of people right now. What's the next season look like? What's the next chapter look like? Is this the house that you want to be in for the next, 4, 5, 6 years? And if not, then now might be the time to really consider making that move. So, the one thing that could have an impact on the market is home builders. They've been pretty gun shy to drive up those the permits to build new single family homes, but I will say that we are definitely seeing an increase. In fact, in July, we had 3,000 permits pulled, and that's a pretty high number. I think that's the highest number since like March of 07 or something like that. So I don't think it was the all-time high. I think the all-time high was back in 04, which was like 6,200, but still you can see that 3,000 is a good solid number. And so that is good. It's helping with this whole inventory squeeze, but it's still not enough. So anyways, I really do think now is a great time for people to just be thinking through, like I said, what's the next chapter look like? So we are here for you as always. If you need anything, we love to chat, love to talk about real estate. If if you want to talk numbers, if you want to poke around and see what's available. I will also say one last thing is that our office, our Sotheby's office, we have a lot of office exclusive listings right now. So that's a big deal when if you have been searching for a home that you like. As you can see, there's not a ton to choose from. So there, we've got like 1,000 agents in our 12 Sotheby's offices, and there's a lot of office exclusive listings that are available. So if you are looking for something, let us know and we can keep an eye out for something that might be a really good fit for you. So we are here for you. We look forward to chatting with each of you very soon. And if you need anything, please reach out. If you need a contractor, reach out. If you need data, reach out. Whatever you need, we're here. All right, we will see you next time. Okay, bye-bye.